Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied that the gas can be also liquefied by giving a particular pressure and lowering the temperature. So now based on that theory, we are now going to learn about what is Linde's process of liquefaction of air. So let us learn about it. So now, as you could see that we are now talking about Linde's process of liquefaction of air. In this, it states that Linde's process is known as adiabatic expansion of a compressed gas. And what does it mean? We are now going to talk it about later right now. So the principle is, the process is based upon Joule-Thomson effect. So this principle is based upon Joule-Thomson effect. And what is Joule-Thomson effect actually? Joule-Thomson effect is nothing but, when a gas under high pressure is allowed to expand adiabatically through a fine hole in a region of low pressure, so it is now accompanied by cooling. So what happens is actually, when a gas which has been compressed or which has been pressurized at high pressure, so when it is now been it releases from a small hole from where now it enters in a area where it enters in a space where it has low pressure. So now what happens, the gas which was been pressurized or which was been get heated up due to pressure, high pressure, so what happens is when entering through a small hole and allowing itself to accommodate a space where the pressure is very much low, so what happens is the gas will turn, the hot gas will now turn into a cold gas. So this process is nothing known as Joule-Thomson effect. So now let us move back to what we are talking about, that is the Linde's process of liquefaction of air. So in this process, let me give a small synopsis. So basically, this is the setup where a small setup, so as to make you understand that how the liquefaction of air is been possible. So this is the setup where it has been connected through various pipes, which in this a pump is also connected. This zigzag pipes, or basically this zigzag lines, are nothing but the coils that I have represented in that form. And these are the tubes, and this is the whole vessel where the liquefaction of air takes place. So let me give you a small glimpse about that, how does this works, or how does the Linde's process takes place. So this A is nothing but the entrance or the inlet of the air. And as you know that air consists of many gases like nitrogen, oxygen and various gases. So in this case, we have to convert that gas under high pressure into a liquid state. So what happens is, suppose if we are entering the air and the air is entering in the pump, that is vacuum pump, as we could say, that is I have been denoted by B, and the atmospheric pressure that has been maintained, that is more than 100 atmosphere. So what happens is this gas, that is air, it will pull towards the pump, and at a atmosphere of, that is at a pressure of 100 atmosphere, more than 100 atmosphere, so it will pull inwards, and what happens is the gas will get heat up, or the air will get heat up. Because at high pressure, what happens is, if you provide more pressure to the gas, then the gas will get heated up. So this gas which is now being heated should be now cooled. So what happens is, we are now allowing it to pass through the coils. So this is a coil where I have denoted by a C. So this is the coil where the air gets cooled. And as you know that when air gets cooled, basically when the air is getting condensed, the hot air is been getting condensed, so it will turn to in a liquid state. So it is not necessary that the condensation should be pure. Why? Because it is a tremendous amount of heat that for cooling this coil we need water. So therefore the water is being supplied in this coil so as to cool the air. And what happens is when the air gets condensed, so in the air basically the H2 is also present. So in this case the H2 first gets liquefied because it is getting condensed. So it will get condensed in a container known as D. So what happens is we are now liquefying that particular water. So this H2 will be liquefied and it will be released through the tap. But the gas is not being liquefied yet. There will be the presence of air which is now out of basically H2 because we have removed the H2 from the overall air or the mixture of air. So H2 has been released, or H2 has been separated. So in this case what we could see is that the air which is again will be passed through this coil, and this coil is basically made up of copper. So this copper coil has a small hole in it. So this hole, which allows basically to enter in a vessel, and this is a vessel, basically the F is a vessel, or we could say it as a flask. So F is basically a vessel where you could see that there is no pressure is being applied, or the pressure is very much low compared to that of the 100 atmosphere pressure. So what happens is the area that we have got, so the more the area means more the volume, and the pressure will be low. So what happens is the gas that would enter from here now automatically gets cooled, because it is obeying Joule-Thomson effect, and we have recently have studied that what is Joule-Thomson effect. So in this case, what happens is the gas, which is basically a hot gas or hot air that has been passed through this whole setup, will now be getting cooled, and among that few will be getting basically liquefied. So this liquefied gas will get deposited down this flask. And for example, again, suppose if the flask is not containing all the liquefied air, so what happens is the air will again enter in this tube. And again, this air will again be accompanied by the 100 atmospheric pressure of this pump. This pump will allow the 100 atmospheric pressure to the air, and again the gas, or the again the air, will be passed through this coil known as C. Again, it will pass through D, and for example, if again there is a possibility of water, so again that would be separated, or that could be collected. So this will process. This process will go on continuing until all the air that we have passed will be liquefied. So this all the gas will be liquefied. So this process of condensation of the air by using a high pressure pump, and by the process known as, or by the phenomenon that is for cooling, and that process is being obeyed by, that is Joule-Thomson effect. So this two phenomenons that it occurs makes the air now being condensed to in a liquid state. So this was the overall thing of the condensation of the air, and obviously that it happens because of the intermolecular force of attraction. Again, this is a main theory that we are going to talk about, because what happens is air, which has the molecules basically separated from each other with a huge distance. So what happens is if we try to pressurize it, so that kind of pressure will allow the molecules to come closer to each other, and that distance that is now very much less as compared to the an ordinary gas, will allow those gas to get condensed with each other, or to have a more intermolecular force of attraction, which makes them to get liquefied for a longer state. And hence in this case it has been maintained because of high pressure and low temperature, because the temperature has also been cooled now. So at high pressure and low temperature, yes, the gas can be liquefied. So this process was basically known as Linde's process of liquefaction of air. Very much simple, but the setup is very much hectic to do. So I hope you have understood this concept very clearly. So yes, share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.